Good morning, YouTube! This is Mr. Duck and Bo. Both coming at you live with another Hero Factory video review. This time we're taking a look at the brand new Hero Factory Wave 2 Bulk. I was on my Toys R Us, local Toys R Us yesterday. I was hoping to find a couple of new Hero Factory, like Stringer, Voltex, Core Hunter, but the only two on the website I saw were Core Hunter and this guy. Unfortunately, this was the only new hero that I found, and I picked it up. So, as you can see, it's a big one. It's a 15.99 bag, though at Walmart, I figured this size would be $13. I'm not joking. I've seen the prices. So, the bag, and if you look up here, you can just see this beautiful gold top, and it looks just beautiful on bulk. As you can see, there's a lot of new parts that I'm extremely excited for, but if you notice just over there, no prizes, guess who that is? Correct. Core Hunter. That's who Bulk will be fighting. Now, I gotta say, this is pretty good. On the back, you can see that, just zoom in, see, Bulk looks just amazing. He's got the hero cuffs around his chest. Looks awesome. I love that. Also because this is a larger hero, this time you get 300 game points. With the box sets, with Black Phantom and Stormer XL, you got 500. But you're not gonna believe this one. With Speed of Demon, you get a massive 900 game points. Okay, alright, that's it. Enough talking. Let's cut this bag open. See what awesome parts come. Let's cut this bag open and see what we've got. Oh man, I am so excited about this. Alright, so I've sorted out the parts as best as I can. Please excuse the chewing, because my cat's having his breakfast. So, anyway, let's get this started. First up, let's just get these bone pieces out of the way, because I've seen most of them before, except, hold on, wait a minute, oh, this is new for me, comes with a standard hero body, pretty good, pretty standard for a Hero Factory figure. Now, where was I? Oh yeah, I've been wanting some of these because they're perfect on XL Mox. They have one technic hole and a ball connection point. Awesome, just perfect for this. All right, what else? He only comes with one sword hand. Oh, but I'm going to replace that with the two silver hands that I got from a Fire Lord set. What else? We got a lot of Technic stuff. But, here's something I haven't seen before. Little rocket pieces. Now, I'll just do a little build and I'll show you how. This is a little rocket. Cute little rocket. I think it was like this. Whoa. Nope, that doesn't work. Okay, I'll figure it out. I'll have to take a look at the instructions. Oops. Oh, turns out I was doing it right. I have to put the rocket piece here. And then put the cone piece on top. Not too bad. At least I'm glad to see this, but we also have these kendo sticks. I've seen these in Ninjago. There's the Technics. Oh. I need only one of these. Okay, on to armor now. First things first. First, we have Gunmetal Gray. He only comes three, but I have a plan. Bulk only... You know how... A lot of people don't like how Bulk has a stubby left arm. So I did this. I took a second Gunmetal Gray piece and used one of these. Then following the format which the armor places, I can do that. So that's another bone piece I can use. Put that one off the side. And, huh, haven't seen these in a while. These are the blasters from we've seen from CERT from 2.0. Now, fits in a lightsaber bar. R. Now this kind of configuration has been seen with split face before. These are, it's nice to have them in pairs. Alrighty. Oh, I forgot to put these off to the side. Okay, Technic, all these are Technic stuff, but here's something I haven't seen here, a Technic lift arm. I won. Black Leaf comes to three, the third one's gonna go on his back, create his rocket launcher, cool. Alright, what does that leave us with? Well, the good stuff. First up, we have the silver pieces from Hero Factory 3.0 with the next set. Came with one. Two of these. Awesome. Gunmetal Gray. Seen this before. But with these, this is the first time it's a new color for me, silver. Awesome. Okay, now, we go. First things first. Orange armor. We've got two 5-longs, which were introduced with Thorn Racks, and then we have two 3-longs in orange. This was introduced with Next 2.0. I love that. I love it. So awesome. But then we got this little piece right here. This is the bottom half of a shooter. I'll just quickly demonstrate how it looks. Okay, that just looks awesome. Okay, that just looks great. Yeah, this is gonna work. Orange combined with gunmetal gray. Orange and gunmetal gray mix. Personally, I prefer the orange and silver that Next 3.0 has. Come on, just gotta put these two back in the pile. Put these back on. Sorry. What else? Oh! Wow! I didn't expect this. This is a multi-tool eye shield in silver! Praise the Lord! This is awesome. I've got a red one before, but this is cool. But this, we're also getting a black one. But the same color will be used with the new Breakout Stringer. And a black one's coming with Core Hunter. What else? Oh. Beautiful. Gunmetal gray chest piece. I like the gear design. I like the gear printing on this. The gear printing on this puppy. This one looks awesome. And something like this will be perfect for a... This will be perfect on a Metal Face mock I have planned. Oh, next. Oh, perfect. Look what we get. This is a pretty cool armor piece. And these are just as good as the... Are just great. They're perfect. Now, I've never seen these before. But what I believe is that they attach onto armor. That looks great. But this isn't the first figure that comes with this. Nope. As far as I know, Captain America was the first one to use this mold. Amazing. Finally, we've got Bulk's helmet. It's awesome. Love the design. It's cool. Awesome. Comes with an orange Galtorian head. No, you can't see it. I know, I can't see it. But let's... Yeah, I know it doesn't look good with the red pool table. Damn! Gotcha! Boy, that's hard to get out. It's pretty good. Just gotta put these back in. Me. Okay, that's great. Now, before we do the build, I want to show you the instructions. Okay, instruction book. This is cool. It's just as good as before. Instructions, go. Page 27, but if you take a look at the care of the and so we look. Holy hot damn! That looks awesome. Most people don't. If anyone sees this, they're gonna think it's awesome. Well, I do. And this is perfect. And if you ask me, this is the perfect way to fuse these two characters together. I am definitely gonna make this mock. If I do. Looks like a upgraded version of Core Hunter. Alright. Now that we've taken a look at all the parts, let's get this puppy built! Alright, so here we have bulk all completed and looks very good. The build actually took me about 8 minutes to do. What I especially like about this character, about this one, is the chest design. It's very good, and it would be perfect for a metal face mock. He looks great. The armor the top section here with the shoulder pads is similar to DC Heroes Green Lantern. He looks great. The back is pretty covered up, pretty much. Originally, you're supposed to use one of those blue long Technic pins, but I didn't think it looked good. So, luckily, there were two small black ones, so I used that one instead. But I like how they added a Technic arm, lift arm here, for the launcher. He looks kind of bulky. But we've gone back to the traditional left shooter hand for bulk. The instructions have the cuffs in this area, which looks pretty good actually. I especially like these pads on the bottom here. And they'd be perfect as a shoulder armor for you. Fortunately, I know where to get the red ones from the Marvel Heroes Captain America. I'll fix that one up a little, because it looks too bulky. I don't like the excess bone sticking out. But the rocket launcher is just as cool looking. I gotta admit, having this rocket launcher on his shoulder is pretty darn good. But would it help if he had some jets to help? Rocket boots to help him? They did that with Breeze 4-point, with Breakout Breeze, but this is a great figure, and I definitely recommend picking up bulk. But if you can find this guy at your local Toys R Us, I'd say give it a go. But if you're into mock making like myself, just pick it up for the parts. If you thought bulk was cool, just wait till you see some of the other Breakout Wave 2 characters.